أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن حديثنا narrated by أبو هريرة عليه رضوان الله in صحيح بخاري. A man came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. He told him, يا رسول الله, give me an advice. The Prophet told him, لا تغضب. Do not get angry. Do not get angry. And the man repeated his request two more times, and the Prophet gave him the same answer each time he asked the same question. Do not get angry. Now, first, the question is that why specifically that piece of advice? It could be that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, of course, he was a murabbi, a mentor. So he knew that this man in particular needed that piece of advice, because on different instances, somebody else may come to him with the same question. Somebody came to him, Ya Rasulullah, give me an advice. The Prophet would tell him, قل أمنت بالله ثم استقم. Say Allah is my Lord, or believe in Allah, and then hold on to the straight path. So it could be that something that this particular actually person needs. Another thing is that, another reason, is that this anger control becomes a measure. So in other words, if you can control your anger, you can control everything else. That's why the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said in another hadith, ليس الشديد بالسرعة ولكن الشديد الذي يملك نفسه عند الغضب. That the strong person is not the one that can knock people down. The truly strong person is the one that maintains his self-control when he's angry. So as such, then this anger control becomes an indicator of the strength of the person's personality. And subhanAllah, the damage or the harmful effect of anger are so many, whether physically, physiologically, you know, the heart pressure, the blood, all of these problems, and also socially, because the person actually who gets angry and loses control, of course, he just judgment will be impaired, and then he may offend people, and then relationships actually get destroyed in the process. We've seen it happening actually in many instances. Now, why do people get angry? Of course, some people by nature, of course, they're short-tempered, and some people by nature actually they're really more patient and more calm. As the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said to Ashaj ibn Abd al-Qais, that you have two qualities that are beloved to Allah and His Messenger, this patience and carefulness. And he told them that these are two qualities that Allah has created in you. And also sometimes the stress, the person may go through stressful situations, like sometimes when the person is fasting. Some people become very short-tempered when they fast. That's why the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, subhanAllah, he said that if you're fasting and if somebody and try to insult you or offend you, فَلْيَقُلْ إِنِّي صَائِمٌ. He should say, I'm fasting. Even though the person might more easily lose it when he's fasting. But then the fasting becomes actually an exercise in patience. So sometimes people may go through certain situation. And this anger, of course, subhanAllah, might be expressed directly by offending others, by lashing at others. And sometimes the person may repress it in a way, but you will see it actually being expressed in all, you know, in different kind of ways, in different relationship. The person contains it, but he vents it in different way. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Ali Imran,
الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين.
الكاظمين الغيظ, those that control their anger, contain their anger, but sometimes that is not enough. A person may contain it to express it in a different way or a different time. That's why Allah followed that by saying وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, those that forgive others. So they contain their anger and they forgive. And even go beyond that into وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those that are kind to each other. They go an extra step actually into being kind to the others. And I think something is important when we're talking about anger is not for the person never to get angry. There's an interesting saying by Al-Hasan al-Basri. He says, مَنَ اسْتُغْضِبَ وَلَمْ يَغْضَبْ فَهُوَ حِمَارٌ. Excuse me. He says that anyone who's pushed to get angry and he never gets angry is almost like a donkey. Excuse me. Like very insensitive. Nothing moves him. The Prophet ﷺ did get angry when it had to do with the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like when the Sahaba were arguing with one another about the book of Allah. And the Prophet got very upset and he said, you're playing with the book of Allah when I'm still among you, or were certain things happening having to do with the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But when it had to do with his personal rights, the Prophet would give in alayhi salatu wasalam. How do we deal with that anger? How do we contain it? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, in a hadith narrated by Ahmad, he says, عَلِّمُ وَيَسِّرُ وَلَا تُعَسِّرُ وَإِذَا غَضِبْتَ فَاسْكُتْ وَإِذَا غَضِبْتَ فَاسْكُتْ. That when teaching others, you know, try to make things easy. And he mentioned something at the end. He said, when you get angry, be quiet. When you get angry, don't say anything. Because subhanAllah, when the person gets angry, of course, he will not know what he's saying. And the things that you say is already just out. You can't just take them back in. And of course, the damage will already be there. So one thing is to make sure that you don't speak when you get angry. Another thing, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, in a hadith narrated by Abu Dawood, he says, if you're angry and you're standing up, then sit down. If that does not dissipate your anger, then lay down on the floor. You know, if try to imagine a person laying down on the floor and angry at the same time, they don't go together. But the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam telling us, you know, just one thing to do. Of course, another thing is al-isti'adha billah min ash-shaytan rajim, to seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the shaytan, as he said in a hadith, in another hadith. Another thing, of course, is the hadith that we started with. When the Prophet says, do not get angry, it means you have a little bit of control over it. Now, you say, well, I'm angry, I cannot help it. Well, there's a little bit of margin, I think, that we can control, and that's really what we're after. So this margin, if you can actually control it and try to contain it, that will be good. Another, wallahi, practical, probably, piece of advice is try to look at your own reflection in the mirror. Well, I try to do it. You'll be amazed as to what you see. You'll probably see a different person altogether. But look at yourself, how you look when you get angry. This, in the way, it will try to help you stay away from that. Another thing, of course, is to always keep in mind the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a big motivator as to what we do. Always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would reward if the person does it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if things actually do not help, maybe you may want to consider actually a certain program or course in anger management and relaxation techniques. Those will also be helpful, and alhamdulillah, they're available everywhere that we look. Another good training actually is to go to Hajj. You know, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج. If you go to Hajj, if you're in a state of ihram, there's no argument in Hajj. There's no argument, even though everything is going to push you to argue. You're around 3 million people doing things in so many different ways, not in the best way. At the same time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that do not actually argue. So if you can make it actually out of the Hajj while containing your anger, then you can control your anger, inshallah, everywhere. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the strong in this life and in the hereafter. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.